The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
People always ask me, Jonathan Clark, how do you become famous overnight? Okay, are you watching? This is how. You're over my head, I'm out of my mind, thinking I was wrong in the wrong time. It's like I'm rewind, everything is so throwbacky. So, what did you think? It is 2019. You're watching the official YouTube channel of yours truly, Jonathan Clark, and I am proud to announce that it's 2019 and The Undertaker has once again risen from his grave. I am really proud that for the first time in over 7 months, The Undertaker is on a WWE pay-per-view such as Extreme Rules, teaming with Roman Reigns for the first time to take on the first time ever tag team of Shane McMahon and Drew McIntyre, Shane McMahon's number one running buddy these days, along with the likes of Elias. I really appreciate how WWE are giving us more of The Undertaker, seemingly, in 2019. This is the first time since 2015 we're getting a dose of The Undertaker as much as what we've been receiving him over the last number of weeks in WWE. It seems like The Undertaker just appears whenever he wants to, or at least that seems to be the way of WWE when booking The Undertaker over the last number of years. But it seems like we're getting more and more of The Undertaker, like we're getting more and more Brock Lesnar as the months go by, and it's really cool that things are finally coming into fruition for names like The Undertaker and Brock Lesnar, who we never see enough of. I think that if wrestling fans are huge fans of legends, like I've been for years, if you've come to know anything about me over the years, like Brock Lesnar and The Undertaker, I think that we deserve to see more of them rather than being subscribed to the network, which WWE pretty much are subjecting us and forcing us to have to do to see these legends. So it's really cool that we're getting more and more of them as we head through years like 2019 and approach 2020, I think more confidently than we were a couple of months ago when we weren't seeing The Undertaker and Brock Lesnar as much because of their contractual obligations outside of WWE and a professional wrestling ring. But now that Brock Lesnar has the Money in the Bank contract, we don't know when Brock Lesnar's going to show up, who he's going to cash the contract in on, and when he's going to cash the contract in, which is really important to look at. That's a huge factor in the Brock Lesnar equation. And now we don't even know when The Undertaker is going to show up, and he makes these surprise appearances like he did a couple of Mondays back on Monday Night Raw when he interrupted the coast-to-coast on Roman Reigns when he was being double-teamed by Shane McMahon and Drew McIntyre, which set things in motion for this incredible tag team match, which I'm a huge fan of. It's the best match on the Extreme Rules 2019 card, and I think it gives us something to look forward to as wrestling fans, which is something that I can proudly say, because ever since WrestleMania 35, we really haven't had anything to look forward to. For me, the only thing I really had to look forward to was Alexa Bliss challenging for the SmackDown Live Women's Championship against Bayley. Yeah, it seems like payback and Extreme Rules from 2017, just 2 years ago, is repeating itself, and history seems to be repeating itself in the women's division, but at least Alexa Bliss is up now for her sixth championship, which I'm hoping she's going to cash in on the opportunity of acquiring, because she's more than deserving of being a champion in WWE after this road to recovery she had to go through and rehabilitate herself from after her shoulder injury back in October, November of last year, after several matches with Ronda Rousey, and how she was feeling numbness in her arm and her shoulder. So I'm really proud to say that she's rehabilitated from that. But, you know, with how we haven't really been offered much in the way of creativeness in WWE, I think The Undertaker and Brock Lesnar now looming in the shadows is giving us something to look forward to. How do I feel about the tag team of Roman Reigns and The Undertaker? Because we've never seen it before, rather than just one-on-one in tag team competition with The Shield and the Brothers of Destruction. We're at war back in 2013-2014. Now Roman Reigns allegedly retired The Undertaker in 2017. I think this will give us a stamp of finality on that rivalry. Obviously, they have a mutual respect for one another, but it could go the other way, too. I know there are people out there that have a significant amount of doubt when it comes to Roman Reigns and The Undertaker and their loyalty towards one another, because The Undertaker, you damn well had better not forget that The Undertaker has not forgotten what Roman Reigns did to him at WrestleMania, just suffering his second loss in his WrestleMania record, second to Brock Lesnar's victory over The Undertaker a number of years ago, back in 2014 at the 30th anniversary of WrestleMania in New Orleans. So The Undertaker's not forgotten that there was a chance we could see Roman Reigns versus The Undertaker 2 by WrestleMania 36, perhaps. That could very well happen, and this could set things in motion for that, depending on how this tag team match plays at Extreme Rules, either that or SummerSlam, if The Undertaker doesn't face Drew McIntyre, which is another solution or alternative opponent for The Undertaker to have in the way of a storyline, and give him the chance to create and make Drew McIntyre even more famous than what he already was, even if people didn't consider him famous. I think after this match with The Undertaker, he will definitely etch his name in WWE history, especially if he gets a victory over The Undertaker, which I can't see, because The Undertaker's just handed these wins time and time again against people like Rusev and Goldberg, which was a dead-end prediction to be made. Everybody knew that it was a dead-end prediction to be made when it came to Goldberg-Undertaker match at Super Showdown, because these WCW legends seem to fall to names like Triple H and The Undertaker because they're WWE loyal, and WWE is never going to have WCW get one over on them, rather than the exception of the invasion angle back in 2001. So The Undertaker's on a roll these days, getting victory after victory. He's racking them up against people like Rusev, and he's rebounding off the loss of the Brothers of Destruction and DX back at Crown Jewel in November, which was the last time we saw him in the ring. I think that The Undertaker definitely unquestionably slowing down, given his age, given the number of matches he's been in. He's got over 100 pay-per-view victories. I think he's up to about 101 victories on pay-per-view. That is absolutely incredible. Over 100 victories on pay-per-view. Can you even fathom that? So to say The Undertaker and Roman Reigns are going to lose this match would be kind of a ludicrous prediction for any wrestling fan to make. Just think about it. 100 wins on pay-per-view. If you even had that status in professional wrestling, looking at it from the perspective of Booker T being a six-time champion in WWE, WCW history, that's one milestone. But 100 wins on pay-per-view, I mean, that definitely pales in comparison to Ric Flair and 16 world titles. That is absolutely unprecedented. It'll never be happen again in professional wrestling. No matter who you are, male or female, you're never going to be able to do that. What The Undertaker's accomplished is absolutely incredible, and what he has yet to accomplish is going to be even more phenomenal, with no disrespect going towards AJ Styles and everything he's doing on Raw now, coming up from SmackDown Live. I think he's going to have just as huge of an impact on Raw as he did on SmackDown Live, calling it the house that he built. I wonder what he's eventually going to claim Monday Night Raw for being. AJ Styles is a phenomenal performer, and we have reason to believe in everything that he's doing, just as we have reason to believe in everything The Undertaker is doing and accomplishing. It is absolutely incredible. Am I still as big of an Undertaker fan as I was 15 years ago? Yes. I am just as big of a fan of The Undertaker as I was when I was in my early 20s, and I'm still just as big of a fan of The Undertaker in my early 30s. And I'm going to continue to be a huge fan of The Undertaker and supporter of the dead man until I can no longer breathe. Honestly, huge fan of The Undertaker, like millions. I think I can proudly say and speak for everybody out there, which I tend to do a lot on this YouTube channel, which often I've apologized for doing, but I think I can get away with saying that I'm not the only one on the Undertaker fan wagon, the proverbial bandwagon of The Undertaker, because I think that millions like myself likewise are just as proud and excited with The Undertaker showing up on July 14th. That's a Sunday night. That's the next time they do it on pay-per-view and on their network. If you haven't subscribed to it, The Undertaker's Return should be a reason for you to subscribe to it. I know we complain all the time. There are too many pay-per-views. There is too much to take in. There are too many programs, especially with the acquisition of the network now by WWE. But if there is a reason to subscribe and there is a reason to watch over 15 hours of WWE programming a week, it's the fucking Undertaker, and if not that, every phenomenal talent they have on this new talented initial roster, which is going to send shockwaves up and down the foundation of the professional wrestling industry and the very core that it was built from, because this is absolutely unbelievable. The dead man has risen. If you haven't already heard about it, head over to WWE.com, tell your friends about it, and share this video. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will check in with you again when I once again stream another video for you on my YouTube channel, which of course is YouTube.com/JonathanClark22. You know the URL, the Universal Redirectional Link. Make sure you subscribe to it if you haven't at the top of the channel, and I will check in with you again really soon. So long for now.
HEW Entertainment Radio is a production of HEW Entertainment on their official website and broadcasts on social media. You can join the conversation on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, follow and listen to our show on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and watch us on our YouTube channel at JonathanClark22. Hosted and produced by Jonathan Clark out of Canada, if you have any questions on our radio broadcast, you can email us at JonathanClark2005@hotmail.com. Thank you for listening.